हेलो। गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल ऑफ यू। आई होप आई एम ऑडिबल टू यू एंड माई स्क्रीन इज ऑल्सो विजिबल। इफ एनी प्रॉब्लम प्लीज लेट मी नो इन बिटवीन द लेक्चर। ओके, सो वी हैव स्टार्टेड आवर यूनिट नंबर 7 आई थिंक 4 आवर्स बैक, राइट? 4 आवर्स डिस्कशन वी हैड मेड एंड वी हैव सीन वेरियस control charts, right? Variable type of control chart, attribute type of control chart. We have seen when to use which chart, and we have seen various examples of control charts, and we have drawn also, right? So with the help of some formulas for P chart, C chart, X chart, R chart. So there are various formulas, and we have calculated the mean and UCL and LCL, and we have drawn the such a control charts, right? We have drawn, I think, last lecture this P chart, right? Two examples we had seen, C chart also, right? And I think we have started discussion on acceptance sampling, right? There we have seen what is the meaning of 100% inspection, what is a sampling inspection, right? So 100% inspection name itself is telling the all components you need to inspect. So that is nothing but the 100% inspection. And what is the sampling inspection? A few components from that lot you can take for inspection. That is a sampling inspection that we have discussed. Right, and we have seen why it is important, right? So what is the purpose of sampling inspection? Most of the time it is very difficult to check the quality of 100% components, because components are more. So to just check whether lot is good or bad, for that purpose this sampling inspection is important. That we have seen various advantages of sampling inspection also. So most of the time when destructive testing is necessary to check the component, so you cannot make the destruction of all the components, right? So at the time of that sampling inspection is required. That we have seen various advantages. Limitations also we have seen, like there is a wrong decision maybe because you are taking few sample decisions. So that was the limitation that we have seen. We have seen its success depends on how many factors, like randomness of sample, sample size, lot size, acceptance criteria, like that points we have seen on which this success of sampling is depends. And I think we were at this point, like industrial use of acceptance sampling. So today we are going to discuss this acceptance sampling related some aspects, and we are going to see the types of sampling plans, sampling plans, and OC curve is one of the curve which guides people in quality department. And at the end of this lecture we'll discuss the MCQs, okay, and we'll conclude this unit today. So let us start with the discussion on industrial use of acceptance sampling. So why this is important? Obviously in quality department it is important, but let us see why it is important. So, So in industry, this acceptance sampling plays very important role, and people use it. So when it is important, when you want to check the incoming raw material, components or products. So its acceptability for that purpose, sampling is important. Suppose you have imported component of a certain category or quality of a certain metal or chemical composition you have decided, and you have called that, ordered that particular material. So whatever incoming material is as per the specification or not, for that purpose, this acceptance sampling is very important. Same for components, same for product, for all the things. Whenever you are purchasing the component, product, material, that time acceptance sampling is important. Also, to decide the acceptability of semi-finished product for further processing as it undergoes the operation from machine to machine or section within the factory. So not necessary like whenever you are calling your component in your industry and checking the quality. No. Actually, in your regular production also, you have to continuously check the acceptability of that semi-finished product. If that semi-finished product itself is a defective, what is the use of that component to process further, right? So machine to machine, you are going to produce the product, right? Machine to machine operations are required within the factory. One machine, suppose you are making drilling, on another machine you are making milling or threading, like that operations you are doing. Suppose out of these three, one operation is defective. Let us say threading part is defective, but remaining two operations are okay. It will be rejected, right? So after every operation, whatever semi-finished product is there, that time you have to check the quality continuously. फक्त प्रोडक्ट सगळा बनल्यानंतर क्वालिटी चेक करायची नाही. सो इन दिस केस यू कॅन सेव द मनी. होलच खूप मोठं झालं असेल तिथे ड्रिलिंग मोर दॅन रिक्वायरमेंट. वॉट इज द पर्पज टू प्रोड्यूस ऑर डू द ऑपरेशन फर्दर? देर इज नो यूज. डेफिनेटली इट विल बी, इट इज गोइंग टू रिजेक्ट. सो इन अर्ली स्टेज इफ यू रिजेक्ट दॅट कंपोनंट, यू कॅन सेव द टाइम, मनी अँड ऑल दिस थिंग. So this acceptance sampling in industry also, in ongoing production also, it is important. Also, it is important to determine the quality of outgoing products. Definitely, you should continuously check the component during production as well as at the last, while dispatching the product, you should check the quality. And their acceptance sampling plays important role. Also, for improving and maintaining the and controlling the quality of the product manufactured. You will get the idea, like, yes, there is always defect on so and so machine. So you will try to improve there, right? Whatever mechanisms you will implement, and you will try to improve further. So acceptance sampling is important not only in your regular production, as well as it is important whenever you are accepting the component during production, also during dispatching, also, and lifelong, if you say, like, for improvement of the quality, that time it is important. So, these are the uses in industry. So, now sampling plan. There are two sampling plans, single sampling plan and double sampling plan. Okay, so let us see what is it. What is the meaning of single sampling plan? When a decision on acceptance or rejection of lot is made on the basis of only one sample, the acceptance plan is called as a single sampling plan. Try to understand. Single, आपल्याला समजू शकतं. सिंगल सॅम्पलिंग प्लॅन, सिंगल सॅम्पलिंग म्हणजे एकदाच. व्हेन यू पीपल आर मेकिंग डिसिजन, यू आर चेकिंग वन्स ओनली. And you are telling, like, yes, product that lot is accepted or rejected. Getting? You have to check only once. दुसऱ्यांदा चान्स नाही. एकदा हातामध्ये त्या जे काय मटेरियल आलंय, हातामध्ये एक 5-10 कंपोनंट घेऊन ते चेक केले, आणि तुम्हाला वाटलं की बाबा एखादा डिफेक्ट निघाला तर मी ॲक्सेप्ट करेल, पण दोन निघले तर मी करणार नाही या 10 मध्ये, भले लॉट तुमचा 100चा असो 1000चा असो. सो रिजेक्टेड, गेटिंग? सो रिमेंबर, यू हॅव टू चेक वन्स इन सिंगल सॅम्पलिंग प्लॅन, यू हॅव टू चेक सर्टन कंपोनंट इन दॅट लॉट वन्स ओनली. सपोज यू हॅव 50 कंपोनंट्स दॅट लॉट यू रिसिव्ह, वॉट यू विल डू आउट ऑफ दॅट 50? यू विल टेक ओनली 5 कंपोनंट्स, अँड आउट ऑफ दॅट 5, इफ यू अंडरस्टँड लाईक येस एक डिफेक्ट मला मिळाला, लॉट इज ॲक्सेप्टेड. बट इन दॅट 5 यू गॉट द 2 डिफेक्ट्स, मीन्स लॉट इज रिजेक्टेड. Getting? So here certain terminologies are there. N, capital N is a lot size. Then small n is a sample drawn. Sample drawn म्हणजे त्यातून किती काढून घेतले चेक करण्यासाठी. आता 50-50 चेक करणं पॉसिबल नाही, 5च घेऊ शकतो. दॅट इज अ सॅम्पल ड्रॉन. अँड व्हॉट इज द सी? सी इज अ ऍक्सेप्टन्स नंबर. म्हणजे काय? एक असेल सी ची व्हॅल्यू, सो इट विल बी, म्हणजे तो काही डिफेक्ट सापडला तर एकच, नॉट मोर दॅन दॅट. आणि हे कधी करायचं? ओनली वन्स, वेन लॉट इज रिच्ड. व्हेरी सिम्पल, राईट? सो दोज हू विल जॉईन द क्वालिटी डिपार्टमेंट, दे हॅव टू प्ले दिस रोल देअर, राईट? सो दे हॅव टू डिसाईड वेदर टू गो फॉर सिंगल सॅम्पलिंग प्लॅन ऑर डबल सॅम्पलिंग प्लॅन. ना दिस स्मॉल फ्लो चार्ट इज देअर फॉर युअर अंडरस्टँडिंग. सो inspect a sample of n pieces. If number of defects does not exceed c, if it is not exceeding the c, then you people have to accept the lot. And if it is exceeding the c, then you have to reject the lots. Simple thing. Getting? Ekdas bagaycha, but you decide what is the value of C, what is the value of capital N, what is the value of small n. That you have to decide first. And once it is decided, that should be known to who is supplying material to you as well as who is checking quality in your department. Both people should know this number. Getting? So this is about the single sampling plan. Naavatas ahe, single. Ekdas karayacha sampling. Parat nahi. Tyachyavar tharvayacha, accept ka reject. If a lot is rejected, you have to resend. And mang te loko are they rework vagare karun, they can solve the problem, whatever it may be. Now, double sampling plan. Name itself is telling, double, 2 times sampling you have to do. So, in a double sampling plan, the decision on acceptance or rejection of the lot is made on the basis of 2 samples. How you will decide whether lot is accepted or rejected? Based on 2 samples. You have to draw 2 samples there. Getting? So, what is the N1 number of pieces in a first sample? N1 you have to draw from whatever lot you received. Let it be 500 component. Let us understand. एक्झाम्पल आय हॅव मेन्शन्ड हियर. 500 तर चेक करणं शक्य नाही. सो व्हॉट यू कॅन डू? नंबर ऑफ पीसेस इन फर्स्ट सॅम्पल यू हॅव टू ड्रॉ. व्हॉट इज द व्हॅल्यू? सपोज यू विल टेक 35 कॉम्पोनंट्स. गेटिंग? यू हॅव टेकन 35 कॉम्पोनंट. देन व्हॉट इज ऍक्सेप्टन्स नंबर फॉर फर्स्ट सॅम्पल? दॅट इज 1. यू हॅव ड्रॉन 35 कॉम्पोनंट, अँड इफ यू विल गेट ओनली 1 defects in that lot, then lot is accepted. So value of C1 is a 1. What is the N2? Number of pieces in a second sample. How many? Let us take example of 50. Out of that 500 lot, you have taken 50 components to check the quality. And if you found the defects, only C2. That is acceptance number. C2 is acceptance number for second sample. But it is a combined. Okay, C2 acceptance number is a combined. So let us take the example, C2 value is a 4. Getting? Now, very simple thing. Once you received the lot of 500, what you have to do? You have to take the certain component, 35 components you have taken, and you have to start checking the quality of 35 components continuously. If you found one defects, no problem, lot is accepted. If it is going beyond that, lot is rejected. C1 value may be anything, you can decide it. C1 may be 2, 3, 4. Okay, as n increases, n1 also it is going to increase, and then C1 is also going to increase. Okay, so this is a double sampling plan. Simple thing, you have to check the twice. So now see the flow chart of this particular double sampling. Suppose you have to inspect N1 pieces. You got the lot of capital N, okay? And you have to inspect the N1 pieces. Take some samples. If the number of defects does not exceed the C1, accept the lot. Very simple logic. At the first stage. Getting, if defects are more than C1 but less than C2, what you have to do? You have to take the second sample of N2 pieces. C1 pesha defect aale mag reject nahi karayse lages. What we have done in earlier case. What you have to do? You have to wait. You have to take the second sample. So this is the one step. What is the third step? If it is exceeding C2 in the first plot, in the first sample itself, C1 C2 ची व्हॅल्यू तुम्हाला माहिती आहे, रिजेक्ट द लॉट इमिजिएटली. पहिल्या स्टेजला C2 एक्सीड होते, सो रिजेक्ट द लॉट. बट इफ डिफेक्ट्स आर मोर दॅन C1 बट लेस दॅन C2, देन इन दॅट केस यू हॅव टू गो फॉर द सेकंड सॅम्पल. दुसरा चान्स द्यायलाच पाहिजे इथं, बरोबर. टेक द सेकंड सॅम्पल ऑफ N2 पीसेस. देन इफ नंबर ऑफ डिफेक्ट्स इन द फर्स्ट अँड सेकंड सॅम्पल कंबाइंड, रिमेंबर हियर यू हॅव टू कंबाइन द samples N1 plus N2. If in this case, if defects does not exceed the C2, then you have to accept the lot. But here also, if it is exceeding the C2, reject the lot. Okay, so C1, C2, C value plays very important role in the both the sampling plan. Sadhi goste. Getting? So in industry, defects are going to be there, but you have to give certain limit. 100% efficiency shakya ka mechanical madhe aplyala sagles component barobar yetil, ek sudha chukicha nasnar ahe. In mass production it happens. Manual error, machine error, material problem, dispatching problem, problems may be anything. Due to that, there may be the defects, there may be the rejection, okay, but it should not exceed beyond the certain limit which we have decided. Very common sense, right? So that is called as a double sampling plan. Okay, so these are the two sampling plans. So now another one of the important point, that is operating characteristic curve, or it is also called as a OC curve. Just look at this curve. Even you can draw also certain points, because on this particular curve you will find so many MCQs in the examination. So if you see this operating characteristic curve, on x axis there is a proportion of defectives, and on y axis there is a probability of acceptance. So this graph is drawn from 0 to 1 limit probability. So it is a probability based graph. So we are going to discuss all the terminologies which are there in this OC curve. So if you found this certain terminology, producer's curve, if you draw, then you will understand all the terminologies. So draw and write the certain terminologies which are there. So you can see the producer risk. Then you can find here acceptability, acceptable quality region, or AQL. acceptance quality limit, then indifferent quality region, LTPD, consumer's risk, objectionable quality region. So these are the terminologies. Let us understand first. So this is probability based graph. So let us understand what is the meaning of producer's risk, consumer's risk, what is the acceptance quality region, what is the LTPD, right? Objectional region. म्हणजे काय थोडक्यात हा ग्राफ कशाचा आहे? आपल्याला हा ग्राफ सांगेल की कोण कुठल्या रिस्कमध्ये आहे. वेदर कंज्युमर ॲट द रिस्क ऑर प्रोड्युसर ॲट द रिस्क, व्हॉट इज द ॲक्सेप्टन्स क्वालिटी रिजन, कितीपर्यंत ॲक्सेप्ट केला पाहिजे. सो जस्ट ग्राफिकल रिप्रेझेंटेशन इट इज. सो लेट इज अंडरस्टँड सर्टन टर्मिनॉलॉजीज इन दिस पर्टिक्युलर ग्राफ अँड देन वील प्रोसीड टू डिस्कशन ऑन एमसीक्यू. ओके, सो प्रोड्युसर्स रिस्क नेम इट सेल्फ इज टेलिंग हु इज अ प्रोड्युसिंग दॅट कंपोनंट, दॅट पर्सन इज हॅविंग सर्टन रिस्क. सो व्हॉट इज इट? इट इज द प्रॉबेबिलिटी ऑफ रिजेक्शन ऑफ अ गुड लॉट विच अदरवाइज वुड हॅव बीन ॲक्सेप्टेड. म्हणजे काय की माझं प्रॉडक्ट सगळं चांगलं होतं, सगळ्या गोष्टी माझ्या चांगल्या आहेत, पण तरी लॉट तिथं माघारी जातोय. सो हूज रिस्क इट इज? प्रोड्युसर्स रिस्क. गेटिंग? सो इट इज अ प्रॉबिलिटी ऑफ रिजेक्टिंग अ लॉट दॅट अदरवाइज वुड हॅव बीन ॲक्सेप्टेड. हे प्रॉबिलिटीजवर आहे ना. तुम्ही काय कंपाऊंड सॅम्पलिंगमध्ये 500 कंपाऊंड आले, 5-10 उचलताय, ते चेक करताय, त्याच्यावरून सांगताय लॉट घ्यायचा का नाही, माघारी पाठवताय. सो तुम्हाला नेमके डिफेक्टच हातात आले तर ऑल कंपाऊंड आर ओके, बट ओनली यू फाउंड द ओनली डिफेक्टिव्ह कंपोनंट. हु इज ॲट द रिस्क? प्रोड्युसर. अँड हु इज व्हॉट इज द कन्झ्युमर रिस्क? इट इज अ प्रॉबेबिलिटी ऑफ डिफेक्टिव्ह लॉट बीइंग ॲक्सेप्टेड विच अदरवाइज वुड हॅव बीन रिजेक्टेड. कन्झ्युमरने काय केलं, जे काही कंपोनंट 500 जे काही हातात आले 5-10, आणि ते सगळे ओकेच होते, पण खाली सगळे रिजेक्टेड आहे, म्हणजे खराबच कंपोनंट आहेत. हु इज ॲट दिस रिस्क? कन्झ्युमर. सो इट इज अ प्रॉबेबिलिटी ऑफ डिफेक्टिव्ह लॉट बीइंग ॲक्सेप्टेड विच अदरवाइज वुड हॅव बीन रिजेक्टेड. सो दॅट विल बी द कन्झ्युमर्स रिस्क. व्हॉट इज ॲक्सेप्टन्स ॲक्सेप्टेबल क्वालिटी लिमिट? It is a maximum percent defect that can be inspected. That is a acceptance quality level. So it is defined as the maximum percent defect that for the purpose of sampling inspection can be considered. That is a acceptable quality level. Then what is a rejected quality level? Basically, it is also called as a lot tolerance percent defective. So, most of the terms are there in a MCQ. So, try to understand what is the LTPD? Lot tolerance percent defective. So, what is this? Actually, this is the unsatisfactory quality. Okay. And it represents the proportion of the defective which consumers find definitely unacceptable. So at the LTPD, customer will definitely reject your lot. So that is a rejected quality level. Maje rejected quality level tita 100% tumcha lot reject hoil, but acceptable cha thikani, even though there are certain defects, up to maximum defect, that person can accept the lot. That is a acceptable quality level. Okay, so these are the certain terms, and another one is a indifferent quality level. So this is the quality level somewhere between EQL and RQL. So what is the indifferent quality? It is a basically difference between EQL, acceptance quality level, and rejected quality level. So whatever difference is there, that is a indifference quality level. All right. So this is about this particular graph. Okay, so about this graph, nobody will ask you to draw the graph and explain the terminologies. What will be asked there, there will be the most of the time MCQs based on this particular graph. So many times MCQs are asked on this particular unit. So let us discuss some of the MCQs. So we have to discuss these MCQs maybe for your unit, your MCQ test 7. This MCQs are important as well as for your university examination. This MCQs are important. Let me zoom in and let us discuss one by one. I expect response from you people. So those who were listening the lectures regularly, they can easily answer such a simple questions. That very simple questions are there. Let me zoom in so that you can see clearly on your screen. Okay, so I hope questions are visible to you people. Along with me, you also can read the questions. Continue reading. And your probable answer you can put in chat box for first MCQ. Just now we have discussed this question. Right, so I think double sampling plan, we have discussed on this. So what is your guess? What is your answer? Can you see the question clearly? Or I will read. In a double sampling plan, if the first sample neither good enough nor bad enough, then the decision on acceptance or rejection is based on the evidence of last two combined, first and last combined, first and second sample combined, and first three combined. So that way in double sampling plan, we are going for only first and second. Okay, so answer is a first and second sample combined. You will go and that evidence will tell you that compound is accepted or rejected. Right, so that we have discussed in sampling plan. So I expect answers from you, your side. So some of the questions are so easy. Okay. Second number question. The items are subjected to fill in the blank test must be inspected by sampling inspection. Quality, destructive, production, single. Question is like that. Here it is expected answer from you. Like which components are inspected by sampling inspection? Which items are inspected by sampling inspection? In which case? That answer. So in advantages of sampling, we have discussed. Any guess? At least you should answer this. Yes, any guess? Such a simple questions you should answer. We have discussed already, right? When sampling inspection is required. Have you understood sampling at least? Sampling manje, sampling inspection and 100% inspection. He don't go to 100% inspection made ek na ek compound upon check karto. And sampling inspection made fakta tharavik कॉम्पोनंट जे तुमच्या हाताला येतील रँडमली यू टेक इट अँड यू इन्स्पेक्ट इट. समजले? सो नाउ एटलीस्ट यू शुड आंसर दिस. कभी सैम्पलिंग इंस्पेक्शन लागत. फ्रेंड्स व्हेन डिस्ट्रक्टिव टेस्टिंग इज देयर मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम यू कैनॉट डिस्ट्रक्ट ऑल द कंपाउंड्स. इफ यू हैव रिसीव्ड 1000 कंपाउंड लॉट यू कैन टेक 5-6 एंड यू कैन मेक डिस्ट्रक्टिव टेस्टिंग नो प्रॉब्लम. सो 100% इंस्पेक्शन इफ इट इज रिक्वायर्ड सो यू विल डिस्ट्रक्ट ऑल द कंपाउंड्स. देर इज नो सेंस ऑफ दिस राइट. सो आंसर इज ए बी डिस्ट्रक्टिव टेस्टिंग. प्लीज ट्राई टू आंसर सिंपल क्वेश्चंस. The probability of rejecting a good lot, third number question I am reading. The probability of rejecting a good lot which otherwise would have been accepted is called as rework, consumer's risk, producer's risk, or okay good. Now obviously it is related to consumer risk and producer risk. कोणाची रिस्क आहे, कंझ्युमरची आहे का प्रोड्युसरची आहे. द प्रोबॅबिलिटी ऑफ रिजेक्टिंग गुड लॉट विच अदरवाइज वुड हॅव बीन ऍक्सेप्टेड म्हणजे काय, की चांगला लॉट आहे, गुड लॉट आहे, बट रिजेक्शन होऊ शकतं जो काय घेणारी पार्टी आहे त्यांनी सॅम्पलिंग केलं आणि त्यांना वाटलं हे सी व्हॅल्यू खूप मोठी येते यांची, पण तो तसा एवढा काय लॉट खराब नव्हता. हूज रिस्क इट इज. आर यू पुटिंग आन्सर इन चॅट बॉक्स? हॅलो, ॲटलीस्ट समबडी. हूज रिस्क इट इज. Any guess? समजा तुम्ही प्रोड्युसर आहात, तुमचं कॉम्पोनंट तुम्ही बनवलंय, चांगला लॉट बनवलाय तुम्ही, so I was talking about you are producer, you have sent good lot, but there is a probability who is purchasing your component, that person has taken the only defective product. 1000 madhe tanna gahle 5-10 barobar defective component tanni baghitle sampling karun, pat tasa pahayla gela tar to component lot evda kharab nahota, but ती प्रॉबिलिटी जी नेमके डिफेक्टिव्ह प्रॉडक्ट त्या व्यक्तीला सापडण्याची प्रॉबिलिटी जास्त असेल आणि त्याने बरोबर डिफेक्टिव्ह कॉम्पाऊंड हाताला लागले त्याच्या, मग कोणाची रिस्क आहे ही? प्रोड्युसर्स रिस्क. गेटिंग? सो आय होप यू आर अंडरस्टँडिंग व्हॉट आय एम टेलिंग टू यू. व्हॉट इज एक्यूएल in this QC chart, we have QC graph, we have seen AQL. Any guess? Few minutes back I have told this long form of AQL. Average quality level, acceptance quality level, average quality limit, acceptance quality limit. Sabhe sarkas dishtay ka? So long form of AQL is acceptance quality limit. Okay, so long forms you can remember LTPD, लॉट टॉलरेंस, परफेक्ट डिफेक्टिव लॉट टॉलरेंस, पर्सन डिफेक्टिव लॉट टॉलरेबल, पर्सन डिफेक्टिव लॉट टॉलरेंस, प्राइस पीस डिफेक्टिव। व्हाट इज द आंसर? एटलीस्ट आंसर वन। In a QC chart, we have seen lot tolerance percent defective. Okay, LTPD stands for it. AOQ stands for average outgoing quality. Okay, so try to remember these three long forms. Most of the time asked in examination. So try to remember. Next question, seventh number. The number of items in a sample is called as number of item in a sample is called as काय म्हणतो आपण sample size. Okay. Next question. Very simple terminology. Try to understand. So these questions were asked in a previous examination. So there may be chance to repeat such a small questions. The success of sampling inspection depends on kashyavar success depends asta how much lot size is there, what is the sample size is there, what is the acceptance number are all. So success of sampling inspection is depends on all these factors, that is lot size, sample size, acceptance number. So answer is a D. Then next question, ninth number. The maximum number for allowable defective in a lot size is called as म्हणजे सी व्हॅल्यू काय म्हणतो आपण सीला लॉट नंबर ओके नंबर रिजेक्शन नंबर ऍक्सेप्टन्स नंबर सो दीज थ्री थिंग्स देर इज नो सेन्स सो ऍक्सेप्टन्स नंबर आन्सर डी इज देर एओक्यूएल So we have seen one more long form AOQ, right? Only L word here it is added extra. So what is the long form? It long form of it. Average outgoing quality that we are knowing. So average outgoing quality level that is a AOQL. Then. Next MCQ. The method of accepting or rejecting a lot is known as lot sampling, acceptance sampling, batch sampling, quality control. What is it? Method of accepting or rejecting, what we call it as acceptance sampling. Related to control chart, certain MCQs are there, 5-6 MCQs. Quantities that can be numerically measured can be plotted on fill in the blank. So which control chart is used when things you can numerically measure? आपण बघितलं होतं एक्झाम्पल लेंथ व्हॉल्यूम वेट प्रेशर टेम्परेचर सो सच अ थिंग्स यू कॅन मेजर न्युमेरिकली राईट सो ऑन विच चार्ट इट कॅन बी मेजर्ड वी हॅव सीन फर्स्ट चार्ट इन डिस्कशन सो एक्स बार चार्ट ओके P charts generally for percentage defective we can use. Right. So answer is a X here. Now A. That is X bar. Next question. A single measurable quality characteristic such as a dimension, weight, or volume is called as variable attribute, variable and attribute, mean and variability. आपण काय म्हणलो होतो दोन टाईपचे चार्ट्स बघितले होते व्हेरिएबल चार्ट्स अँड अट्रिब्यूट टाईप ऑफ चार्ट्स सो व्हेन व्हेरिएबल चार्ट शुड बी प्रिपेअर्ड व्हेन थिंग्स कॅन बी मेजर्ड सच एज डायमेन्शन वेट व्हॉल्यूम सो दिस वेट व्हॉल्यूम दीज आर दी यू कॅन से व्हेरिएबल्स ओके सो आन्सर इज ए दॅट इज व्हेरिएबल अँड अट्रिब्यूट मीन्स maybe smell good or bad accepted rejected that kind of things that are the attributes now tell me toughness of the bolt mounted on the tank is whether it is attribute it is variable or an attribute or variability so toughness can you measure the toughness Yes, so it is a variable. And if another question I will ask like odor, so smell kind of thing, smell, bad, good. Can you measure, there is a certain measurable thing? So no, it is an attribute. Okay, so next question, X chart is A. कुठला आहे हा एक्स चार्ट वेदर इट इज अट्रिब्यूट कंट्रोल चार्ट ऑर व्हेरिएबल कंट्रोल चार्ट ऑर नायदर ए व्हेरिएबल कंट्रोल चार्ट नॉर ए अट्रिब्यूट कंट्रोल चार्ट फॉल्स इन कॅटेगरी ऑफ बोथ व्हेरिएबल अँड अट्रिब्यूट कंट्रोल चार्ट व्हॉट इज इट एक्स चार्ट इज अट्रिब्यूट टाईप ऑफ व्हेरिएबल टाईप डेफिनेटली दिस सी अँड डी इज नॉट देअर सो एक्स चार्ट All charts comes under the two things only, that is attribute control chart and variable control chart. So, in which category X chart falls? Remember, X and R charts falls under the variable control chart. And P and C control chart comes under the attribute type. Okay, so X is a variable control chart. Now, this question already I have answered now, few minutes back, 16 number. C chart is A. Which type of control chart? There is no logic required to answer this. Definitely, a variable attribute type of control chart. This is a true or false. The lower control limit for an X bar control chart is lesser than the mean of the sample taken. Is it the true sentence or false sentence? Question cha artha asa ki lower limit control chart sa he mean peksha kami asta. Is it true? Definitely true. Because lower limit hai mean cha nehmi khali asta. So it is a less. Below that it is a less and upper it is a more than mean. Okay, so it is a true sentence. Can somebody tell me the calculation? How we calculate LCR, lower control limit for R chart? How to calculate? We have done calculation. How to calculate LCL? Anybody remember formula? R chart while doing for every chart LCL and UCL is required. Can anybody remember the formula? Try to remember such a small formulas. So D3 into R, that is the LCL limit that we have seen in R control chart. So formula is a D3 R. The next question, second last question, what type of charts will be used to plot the number of defective in the output of any process? कुठला चार्ट वापर थिंग्स विच वी कैन मेजर एक्स एंड आर चार्ट इज देयर बट नंबर ऑफ डिफेक्टिव आपण टायरचं एक्झाम्पल बघितलं होतं डिस्कशन मध्ये टायरचा लॉट होता त्याच्यामध्ये परसेंटेज डिफेक्टिव किती आहेत विच चार्ट वी रेफर टू ड्रॉ इट टायरचं एक्झाम्पल मध्ये एनीबडी रिमेंबर्ड पी चार्ट ओके सो देर आर ओनली फोर चार्ट एक्स बार एक्स चार्ट आर चार्ट सी चार्ट पी चार्ट सो ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड यूज ऑफ ईच एंड एवरी चार्ट एंड हाउ टू कैलकुलेट यूसीएल एंड एलसीएल सो विच अमंग द फॉलोइंग इज द टाइप ऑफ कंट्रोल चार्ट फॉर वेरिएबल आई थिंक दिस क्वेश्चन इज रिपीटेड At least for repeated question, you should answer. Variable X chart, okay. Just put your number in chat box. Don't leave the meeting. Just put number in chat box. So up to this we have completed 7th number unit. Tomorrow we'll start 8th number unit. Maybe within 4 hours we can complete it. 3 to 4 hours are necessary to complete unit number 8. Okay, so in this week we can complete our all discussion of IPM. Put your number and leave the meeting now.